innovation and startup ecosystem in engineering institutions. Dr. Geeta Tripathi ma'am completed her BE, DBM, MBA, ME in Embedded System and Engineering, PhD research on Dynamic Administrator Gateway in MGA for performance improvement in WMN. She has a total of 24 years of teaching experience. Working as a member, Institute Level Committee for NAC, Maharashtra Institute of Technology, and Administrative Audit Committee for Laboratories. She is a reviewer of International Conference ICACCC 2021 at RAIT. Reviewers for Spandan 2013 National Conference on Advances in Engineering, Technology and Applied Sciences organized by Priyadarshini Institute of Engineering and Technology. Geeta ma'am also received Best Paper Award in IEI Annual Paper Meet. Expert for pre-PhD submission seminar of two registered candidates of RTM Nagpur University at PIET Research Center. She has also published many technical papers in international journals and conferences and a book on IT trends and technologies published by Narendra Publications. And the research areas are wireless networks and cognitive IoT. Thank you.
Thank you, Shweta Sri. Now I request our Honorable HOD Sir, Dr. S.P. Yadav Sir, to address the gathering.
Thank you, Madam, and thank you all. First of all, good afternoon to one and all who are present, and a very good afternoon to Dr. Geeta Tripathi, who is our expert speaker on the topic Innovation and Startup Ecosystem in Engineering Institutions. Madam, I welcome you on the behalf of Electronics and Communication Engineering Department of Guru Nanak Institute of Technology, Ibrahim Patnam, Hyderabad. We are highly indebted that you will be delivering a very thoughtful session to our students and faculty members who will get a lot of benefit from your lecture, and they may start thinking in terms of innovative ideas, and then may start their own startup and become a very successful entrepreneur in future. So thank you for sparing the time and coming here. So without wasting a lot of time, I hand over this platform to you and deliver this lecture. Once again, thank you very much for coming here. Okay, over to you, Madam Dr. Geeta Tripathi.
Thank you very much, sir. I am really delighted to be part of this webinar. Thank you. Thanks for having me. I'll share my screen and minute. By the time, am I audible clearly?
You are audible.
Okay. A minute.
I think to allow her to share her screen, we have to first stop screening from our side.
So yes, sir. I have stopped.
Okay.
Sir.
Okay. Have stopped.
So is the screen visible now?
Yes, madam.
Okay. So the topic of webinar is orientation session on innovation and startup for students and faculty. The outline of this presentation is introduction, preamble, vision, National Innovation and Startup Policy 2019 for students and faculty, first areas of the policy, highlighting features, strategies, and governance, and the conclusion. What is innovation? The word innovation is derived from the Latin verb innovare, which means
to renew. Innovation means to improve or to replace something. For example, a process, a product, or a service, when we try to improve it or we want to replace it with something better, we call it as innovation. So innovation is a process by which a domain, a product, or a service is renewed and brought up to date by applying the new processes, introducing some new techniques, or establishing some successful ideas to create a new value. The creation of value is a defining characteristic of innovation. So when we talk about innovation, we need to have certain value added to it. And what is a startup? The term startup refers to a company in the first stages of operation, in the initial phases of operation. So startups are founded by one or more entrepreneurs who want to develop a product or service for which they believe there is a demand. As per the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, an entity is considered as a startup up to a period of 10 years from its date of registration, and if its turnover has not exceeded rupees 100 crore. So such a company we call it as a startup. And what is incubation? So these are the terms when we talk about innovation and startup or entrepreneurship. These are the terms which are much related or much needed or talked about around the idea of innovation and entrepreneurship. So incubation is one such term. Incubation is a unique and highly flexible combination of business development processes, infrastructure, and people designed to nurture and grow new and small businesses by supporting them through early stage of development and change. So initially, when there is an introduction of a new company, it needs certain support, and that support we are getting through the incubation. That we call it as the incubation. A business incubator is an organization that accelerates and systematizes the process of creating successful enterprises. So initial phase wherein some support is needed to well establish, to make the enterprise a successful one, we need incubation. So by providing them with a comprehensive and integrated range of support. So this may include like incubator space, business support services, clustering, and networking opportunities. So these are the different things where the support is needed for a newly introduced enterprise. It needs support in these areas. Okay. What is meant by entrepreneur? An entrepreneur is a person who takes risk and starts something new. And entrepreneurship is a process of identifying and starting a new business venture. So sourcing and organizing the required resources by taking both risk and rewards associated with the venture. So an entrepreneur is taking the responsibility of the success as well as failure of the new venture. Okay. This entrepreneur is responsible for identifying the areas where a new business or a scope of a new business is there, sourcing and organizing all the required things, basic things, and starting up and making it flow through the business. In in November 2016, All India Council of Technical Education, AICT, released a startup policy document for AICT approved institutions to address the need for inculcation of innovation and entrepreneurial culture in higher education institutions, HEIs. So it was identified as a need of the hour, looking at the job demands or the scarcity of jobs for even after getting the higher degrees for the youngsters in India. So it was promoted that students should get promoted, students should be given a motivation for the entrepreneurship direction, so that they can provide, instead of the job seekers, they should be the job providers. They should be working in the job providing directions. So can we do that? So with this aim in mind, AICT released a startup policy document for all those institutions which are associated with AICT. So the policy primarily focused on guiding the AICT approved institutions in implementing startup action plan of Government of India. Subsequent release of the startup policy by AICT and further interaction and feedback received from the education institutions, a need was felt for a more elaborate and comprehensive policy guiding document which could be applicable for all the HEIs in India. So this is how the startup and incubation and innovation centers in every HEI was begun. A 15-member committee was constituted by Ministry of Human Resource Development under the chairmanship of Professor Ashok Jhunjhunwala, Professor, IIT Madras, to formulate detailed guidelines for various aspects related to innovation, startup, and entrepreneurship management. This committee deliberated on various facets of nurturing the innovation and startup culture in HEIs. Then it covered intellectual property ownership, revenue sharing mechanisms, norms for technology transfer, and commercialization, equity sharing, etc. Because when HEIs are getting involved in entrepreneurship, definitely the faculties, the students, they may be part of that entrepreneurship. So who will be having the ownership over the intellectual property? What will be the, how the revenue sharing will be done between the students, faculties, and the institution? So certain norms were needed for that. After multiple rounds of meetings, National Innovation and Startup Policy 2019 for students and faculties of HEIs were prepared. Keeping this in mind, majorly, now India aspires to become $5 trillion economy by 2024. A certain report says that to reach the mark, it needs to evolve systems and mechanisms to convert the present demographic dividend into high quality technical human resource. Capable of doing cutting edge research and innovation and deep tech entrepreneurship, the National Student and Faculty Startup Policy 2019 is a guiding framework for it. To envision an educational system oriented towards startups and entrepreneurship and opportunities for students and faculties, the guidance provides ways to Indian HEIs for developing entrepreneurial agenda, managing the intellectual property rights, IPR ownership, technology licensing, and equity sharing. In startups or enterprises established by faculty and students. So these guidelines are given for it. In India, innovation is still not the epicenter of education. We are focusing on giving the knowledge, sharing the knowledge, and improving the intelligence rather than making it applicable in the real life more and more to that direction by promoting more and more innovation. So it has been observed that in India, and reports, certain studies say that we don't have much focus on innovation in the past. So in order to achieve the cultural and attitudinal shift and to ensure that innovation and startup culture is the primary fulcrum of our higher education system, a policy framework and guidelines are the need of this. So keeping this in mind, these policies were defined. These guidelines will enable the institution to actively support their faculty, staff, students to participate in innovation and entrepreneurship related activities. Thus, encouraging the students and faculty to consider the startups and entrepreneurship as a career option. Because what happens many times, we get a good project idea, we are having an innovative idea for our projects, the students are having their own idea, the project guides can add on further improved versions to that particular idea, everything is okay, a prototype is built, and how to convert it into an entrepreneurship? That is a difficult question, and the teachers and students and staff and institutions is generally having not much in-depth idea about how to convert this idea, how to materialize this idea as a new startup. So for that, these policies were there, and through this, instead of thinking that we cannot take this idea further, and instead of giving up on materializing or bringing it into practical, this policy is further promoting for improvement in the ideas, support in the ideas, and further improving and encouraging the innovations amongst the faculty, students, staff. So these recommendations and guiding principles will also help HEIs in creating their own policy framework if required. So depending on the area specific, where this institution is and what kind of institution it is, whether medical or technical or sociological or environment-based education. So depending on that, the HEIs can add on their own policies. So there are guidelines given, but specific policies may be added by the HEIs. Moreover, these guidelines will facilitate Ministry of Human Resource and Development in bringing uniformity across the HEIs, because there will be a common agenda, so there will be less differences between in some institution they are getting such and such facilities, why such facilities are not in my institution, and something like that. So there shouldn't be some unrest amongst the students or faculties or innovators, we can say. So for that, a general guideline is there, so that there is uniformity across the HEIs. The term of IPR ownership management, technology licensing, and institutional startup policies, these are also so these will be having the uniformity across the all institutions under AICT. So it should not happen that if I am proposing some idea and that IPR, ownership of that IPR is with my institution and I am hardly 2% or 1% owner in that particular IPR. So in other institution, while in other institution, a faculty is getting 50% ownership on the IPR because the idea was of that faculty. So there should not be such differences. For this, here are the guidelines, uniform guidelines to be followed by the HAIs, the institutions for promoting the startups, and when they are actually implementing these startups, these policies should be followed. So it enables the creation of a robust innovation and startup ecosystem across all the HAIs. These guidelines will help the help emphasize that the entrepreneurship is all about creating a business which is financially successful. So National Innovation and Startup Policy 2019 for Students and Faculty, NISP 2019, was launched by Honorable Minister of Human Resource and Development on 11 September 2019. The policy intends to guide HEIs to promote students and faculty-driven innovations and startups. It will be instrumental in leveraging the potential of students' problem-solving and entrepreneurial mindset and promoting strong intra and inter-institutional partnerships. Now here, many times it may be required that the institution alone is not sufficient to provide all the resources, all the guidelines, and it may need support of some other institutions as well. So inter-institutional partnership is also promoted with supported, should be promoted through this particular NISP 2019. It was proposed like that. So thrust areas of NISP 2019 when it was proposed. HEI strategies and governance for promoting innovation and entrepreneurship. Then creating the innovation pipeline and pathways for the entrepreneurs, building organizational capacity and human resource and incentives required. Then collaboration, co-creation and business relationships and knowledge exchange. After this, the norms for faculty and after making this base, the norms for faculties and students driven innovation and startup, then incentivizing the faculty and students for entrepreneurship. There must be some proper mechanism that what will be the incentives to faculty member and students which are involved in a new enterprise which is developed with the help of HEI, and norms for faculty startup. Even if no student is involved, a faculty or a group of faculty members are having their ideas and they want to go for a startup, then what will be the norms for it? Then incubation and pre-incubation support. Now, after having the base created, the policies designed, now the process starts with the actual implementation. So in the initial phase, the incubation and pre-incubation support is needed. Then IP ownership rights for technologies developed at HEI, who will be having how much percentage of rights. Then pedagogy and learning interventions for supporting innovations and startup further. Like already if some startup is going on, but further we want to motivate and promote even more. So what are the current areas, recent areas, current trends, or the demands in the society, the scope wherein a new thing can be started. So for that, and the technologies that are more demanding, more in use for the startup, so those trainings can be further planned. Entrepreneurial performance impact assessment. So once it has been started up, what is the impact of it? How assessment of how it is working, where it needs improvement, so that in the further upcoming startups, these things can be improved. If there are any flaws, if there is any scope of improvement that can be further done. Highlighting the features of that policy, creation of innovation fund for supporting innovative projects and startups by allocating minimum 1% of the institution's total budget. Academic break for a semester or year to work on the startups. Credit for working on innovative prototype business models that should be given to the students. The next comes the shares. 2% to 9.5% equity stake startup or company by institutes, incubator. Complete ownership of IPR by the inventors in the case of non-usage of institute's facilities or resources. And services to be offered by institutions in lieu of equity fee-based or zero payment model. These are the main features. Then this further states that the strategies and governance for promoting entrepreneurship, it should include major dimension of HEI strategy and should formulate university or HEI level document in accordance with the NISC and the startup policy. Then this should be achieved through mission statements rather than the stringent control system. Entrepreneurial agenda should be the responsibility of a senior person at the level of dean, director, or equivalent position with less hierarchy and autonomy. The intra and inter-institutional relations to promote entrepreneurship and innovation agenda, and institute can provide services and facilities to outsider entrepreneurs too. Once the incubation center is created, the facilities, the resources are available, it can be extended to support the external entrepreneurs as well. Resource mobilization plan should be in place, like own resource, 1% fund of the total annual budget, and raising fund from the diverse sources like state and central agencies, if we can get it through HEIs. We are having different AICT and DST fundraising, like fund allocating schemes. So through that, we can go for it. Incubation fund support under CSR, Section 135 of the Company Act 2013. Then sponsorship, donation from alumni network. So this way we can get the resource, and there should be proper planning how we will be getting it. All HEIs should join the institution's Innovation Council IRC network and participate in Smart India Hackathon SIH and participate in Atal Ranking of Institutions Innovation Achievement. So these were the strategies. Then creating innovation pipeline and pathways for entrepreneurs. HEI to ensure maximum students should participate and go through pre-incubation process of problem identification, solution development, proof of concept validation and prototype development, business model, proposal development. HEI should link and collaborate their incubation unit with external agencies as well, and ecosystem enablers, and provide network support to incubate the startups. Connecting student entrepreneurs with incubate startups for internship, experience sharing, and encouraging participation of students in innovation and business plan competitions, and organize such competitions, hackathons on campus. So this is the way how we can more and more involve the students in the process to observe closely the process of a startup, the process of a new entrepreneurial development. So with the help of participation in the competitions, with the help of being part of such entrepreneurship startups as an intern or a project, the students can get the closed loop and get motivated as well. Then building the organizational capacity and human resource and incentives. Institute should recruit staff that have a strong innovation and entrepreneur or industrial experience, behavior and attitude. This will help in fostering the I&E agenda and culture in HER. So those who are already from the industry, such those who can give the close look and support for entrepreneurship can be recruited separately only for this purpose. The faculty and departments of the institute have to work in coherence and cross-departmental linkage and maximum utilization of internal use resources and knowledge. So only one department cannot go alone for any new startup, maybe needing some support from other departments as well. So it may be possible that robotics based some startup is there, so there will be need of the electronics knowledge, there will be need of mechanical knowledge, there will be need of IoT kind of knowledge, and the also programming kind of thing will be needed. And after setting it up, the marketing and its actual managing business may need the business administration knowledge as well. So there will be several departments working together for making the startup successful. So the faculty and departments of the institute have to work in coherence and cross-departmental linkage, and maximum utilization of internal usage, resources and knowledge should be done. Faculty and staff should be encouraged to do courses, training, certificates on innovations, entrepreneurship and IPR. Then to retain the talent, institute should develop academic and non-academic incentives and reward mechanisms for all staff, faculty and stakeholders. It should not be only dependent on, like it may happen that a faculty is having great ideas and working in that direction, and because not able to do, because getting a little bit overlooked over the regular teaching or some teaching related, academics related things, should not hamper his appraisal. Okay, so appraisal mechanism should also have some points for identifying the talent of the faculty and appreciating it. Otherwise, the talent may leave the institution. So a performance matrix should be developed and used for evaluation as a part of annual performance and contribution of faculty and staff towards achieving I&E agenda should be part of the matrix. So everyone should be promoted for this, motivated for doing such things, and due credit should be given. Collaboration, co-creation and business relationship and knowledge exchange. So under this, institute should develop a policy or guideline document for forming and managing the relationships with external stakeholders, including private industries. Knowledge exchange through collaboration and partnership should be made as a part of institutional policy. Mechanism should be devised by the institute to ensure maximum exploitation of entrepreneurial opportunities with industrial and commercial collaborations. Knowledge development should be done by the institute through development of innovation knowledge platforms using ICT capabilities, repositories of ideas, POCs, innovations and startups can be managed through the platform. So this is how the collaboration can be done, co-creation can be done, because industries also need some help of the educational institutes. Norms for faculty and student-driven innovations and startups. The first thing is incentivizing the students for innovation and entrepreneurship. HEI should establish process or clear guidelines and mechanisms for easy creation and nurturing of startups, enterprises by students of UG, PG and PhD level. Faculty and staff of HEIs by setting up a committee and working committees on the following points. Allow the students to set up startup, social and technical and non-technical or working part-time for the startup while studying, working as an intern. Allowing students to earn credit for working on innovative prototypes or business models. Student innovators, entrepreneurs may allow to opt for startup in place of mini project, major project, seminar, summer training, etc. Allow the student entrepreneurs to take a semester break or a year break if required to work on their startup. Then allowing the student entrepreneurs, innovators to sit for the examination, institute need to set up minimum attendance and after review by committee on case to case basis, the strategies can be formed. If the student is working on an innovative idea on the in the institute and not in the class, then also attendance can be considered and the policy may be decided on case to case basis. Allowing the student entrepreneurs to use the address of hostel or pre-incubation or incubation unit to register their venture while studying in HEIs. So that will make the correspondence easier. Support will be there for the students. Incentivizing faculties for innovation and entrepreneurship. Likewise, the faculty should also be incentivized. So allowing the faculty to start up based on the technology developed in the lab, at the institute or previously developed somewhere else but have ownership of IP if technology based. Then allowing the faculty and staff to take off for a semester or year as a sabbatical or unpaid leave or casual leave or earn leave for working on startup and come back. No restriction on shares that staff and faculty can take as long as they don't spend more than 20% of the office time on the startup in advisory or consultant's role and don't compromise with their existing academic and administrative work or duties. Then in case of faculty or staff is drawing salary from the institute set or equity on startup should be limited to 20% of the total share of faculty or staff or 9.5% of the total stake, whichever is minimum. So this way, certain policies can be formulated. Norms for faculty startup. Role of the faculty while teaching may be as owner, founder, co-founder, director, promoter, or advisor, mentor, consultant, but can't take the role of employee as CEO or other managerial role in his or her startup and can't draw salary from startup and can't accept gifts from his own startup. He or she can take share on profit and dividend only if from startup as owner or shareholder. So faculty must clearly separate and distinguish ongoing research at the institute from the work conducted at the startup or the company. There must be a boundary line where the institute work is there and from where the entrepreneurs as a new companies work is starting. Okay, so there must be some line. In case selection for acceleration or incubation, he may take sabbatical leave or other leave up to one semester or 1 year or more based on the committee recommendation. And faculty must not involve research staff or other staff engaged in academic projects of institutes in activities at the startup. This is again drawing a clear boundary line. Then guidelines regarding incubation and pre-incubation support facilities creation and access. Creation of pre-incubation and incubation. Pre-incubation and incubation support attached with nearest incubation unit if not exist in campus. Promotion and intensifying of technology commercialization efforts. Allow licensing of IPR from institute to startup incubated at the incubation unit. Facility should be accessible to 24/7 to students, staff, faculty of all disciplines and department across the institute. Provision and streamline relevant service and mentoring support to the pre-incubation and incubation unit in return for fees, equity sharing, zero payment basis. Then in return of services offered, like space, infrastructure, mentorship, seed fund, accountant and legal and patent support, and use of facilities at institute or incubation unit may take 2 to 9.5% equity or stake in the startup or company incubated. So in case of compulsory equity model, startup may be given a cooling period of 3 months to use the incubation services on rental basis to take a final decision. Then regarding IP ownership rights for technologies developed at HEIs, if fund or resources of HEIs used substantially, then IPR should be made jointly by the institute and inventor and licensed together and revenue sharing among the parties. If one of the inventors want to start a startup based on the technology developed as above, then it can be licensed to inventor with royalty would be no more than 4% of sales price, preferably 1 to 2%, unless it is pure software product. If it is in the form of shares, then it will be again between 1 to 4%. In case software share divide is based on mutually decided between the institute or incubation unit and the incubate company. On any dispute on IPR ownership and revenue sharing and licensing, then a 5-member committee set up at HEI will look into the matter and recommend. Interdisciplinary research and publication on startup and entrepreneurship should be promoted by the HEI. Then comes the pedagogy and learning interventions by entrepreneurship development. Adopt and produce desirable learning outcomes as a part of curricular, co-curricular, and extracurricular level. Create and publish toolkit on innovation in startup and IPR for open access to students and faculties, student clubs, bodies on innovation in IPR and startup must be established and working engaged. HEI should start recognizing and giving innovation and entrepreneurship awards to best achiever from the campus annually. And confer gold medal kind of rewards during the convocation ceremony. Then teaching on tolerating and encouraging failures. Creating awareness among the students and teaching methods should include case studies of real business stories of failure and success, experiential learning should be there. Pedagogy changes need to be done to ensure that maximum number of students' projects and innovations are based around the life challenges, which should be constantly reviewed and updated. Start a part-time or full-time MS, MBA, PGDM in innovation, entrepreneurship, and venture development course to be offered through incubation unit as per the AICTE guidelines. So not only supporting the startups, but also giving the training and formal training with the proper degrees and diplomas that can be started by the incubation center. Then comes the entrepreneurial performance impact assessment. Once everything is developed, how to go for the impact assessment of the impact. So performance analysis of services and facilitates on regular basis, development of key performance indicators, and focus on input, process, output. After that, outcome and impact level. So to which level it was successful. So these are the general guidelines given, provided, and based on it, the HAIs should work as per the AICT. So this is a already available information that I have shared, and we at Maharashtra Institute of Technology, Aurangabad, we are having MIT Innovation and Incubation Center, wherein we have started with a small startup, and yes, it is working. So during pandemic time, it has worked nicely. The company has given a good performance, and I can show you that this is one of the company that we are having. This is our MIT, Maharashtra Institute of Technology, IIC cell, wherein we are providing several different facilities to students and faculties, and a student faculty startup at MIT, TechnoOrgs, has been running since 2020, and this is TechnoOrgs. It is a LLP, student teacher startup at Maharashtra Institute of Technology, Aurangabad, first of its kind in the Marathwada region. And we work for addressing the real world problems, providing effective solutions in the unique way. So these are the staff and students associated with this, and the products that this TechnoOrgs has developed are these USIE automatic sanitizing liquid dispenser, then temperature scanner, and these are the various services provided by the center. So this is all from my side. Any questions, then most welcome for that. Yes, Premlata ma'am.
Yes, madam, thank you very much for enlightening our students with your wisdom. Recent topic, which is the need of the hour, because our Prime Minister thinks that India should become a 5 trillion nation, and that too by 2024. So we are only left with 3 years, and this is only possible when many startups comes in India, and many entrepreneurs start their contribution towards the nation growth. So once again, on behalf of the Electronics and Communication Department, I thank you for sparing your valuable time and giving a very important lecture to our students. So that a student can take over for the vote of thanks. Yes, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you can proceed.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Soumya, and I'm here to present the vote of thanks for today's webinar on Innovation and Startup Ecosystem in Engineering Institutions by Dr. Geeta Tripathi, Innovation Ambassador. I would like to thank our webinar speaker, Dr. Geeta Tripathi, for visiting and enlightening us with her knowledge. Today's webinar was full of knowledge and interesting things. It gave deep insights into the topic and also revealed some interesting facts. The point where Dr. Geeta Tripathi told us about the guidelines to innovation, strategies, and governance for promoting entrepreneurship was really informative. I am pretty sure the precious knowledge that you gave us will definitely help us in our studies and future. Once again, I would like to thank Dr. Geeta Tripathi for taking out time from their busy schedule and enlightening us with the knowledge. Thank you so much, ma'am. I would also like to thank our principal, Mr. Srinath Reddy, and our HOD, Dr. S.P. Yadav, for giving permission to organize this webinar session and inviting Innovation Ambassador Dr. Geeta Tripathi to conduct it. I must thank our faculty and student committee who really worked hard to make this event successful. Also, thank you to all the students present here for paying your attention and learning. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. I'm really grateful that I got a chance to have an interaction with GNIT. Thanks to Premlata ma'am, Vasanti ma'am, thank you very much for connecting with me. Thanks to Yadav sir, Dr. Yadav, I'm very thankful to you and all the team of yours. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you, madam. Thank you once again. Okay.